Khaled Batafi is a senior columnist from the Saudi Gazette, joins us live from Jeddah. Thank you very much for joining us. How's this playing out in Saudi, this human cost of the fighting?
Well, let us remember that there are more than a million Yemenis in Saudi Arabia, and a lot of them, many Saudis have originally came from Yemen, and we feel like it's a family out there under stress. And many, I just was talking to a Yemeni here who told me he cannot even transfer money to his family, and there are many who would like to go back and help, or those who were having medication here or operations, and they would like to go back, and they are stuck in many different countries, in Egypt, here in Jordan, everywhere. So the human situation, I cannot overestimate the situation there. It's really bad, and we hope the Houthis and their allies will come to their senses and end this misery.
Yeah, you wonder what's going to make them come to their senses, because it seems that the end game is continuing to be confusing.
You are right. The orders haven't come yet from Tehran. They cannot do anything without orders from Tehran. So I think the international community should pressure Tehran instead of the Houthis. And when the Ayatollah and Rouhani and the rest find that this is a no-go game, and it has their ambitions have reached their end, they will come to their senses and will tell their stooges in Yemen to come also to their senses and agree to the terms of the Security Council resolution.
In the meantime, the UN has prompted Saudi Arabia to come up with some money, come up with some funding, some aid. How's it going to get to those who need it?
Well, the UN asked everybody, every member of the UN, to come with help to reach the sum of 274, but then King Salman decided to pay it all at once from Saudi Arabia. And now there is a bridge in Djibouti, and thanks to the Djibouti government for allowing this, with there are ships and airlines going to all cities, including Sana'a, and ports, including Al Hudaydah, to bring aid to those who need it. But the problem is complicated, because how do you distribute the aid in there? There are non-governmental organizations working already, the Red Cross, Doctors Without Borders, and others who are trying to help. And we hope the Houthis and their allies allow this to happen. It helped their own people and the rest of the Yemenis. If they still feel they are Yemenis, they should allow this to happen.
Okay. Khaled Batafi, good to have you on the show. Thank you.